Here's some of the stories trending this week at NASA. A SpaceX Dragon cargo spacecraft launched aboard a Falcon 9 rocket on April 8th from Cape Canaveral Air Force Station in Florida to resupply the International Space Station. Among the almost 7,000 pounds of science research, crew supplies, and hardware being delivered is the Bigelow Expandable Activity Module, or BEAM. This technology demonstration will study the radiation protection, thermal performance, and operations of expandable habitats for possible use on future deep space missions, including the journey to Mars. This is SpaceX's eighth contracted mission to the station under NASA's Commercial Resupply Services contract. NASA Deputy Administrator David Newman and astronaut Katie Coleman were among those invited to help First Lady Michelle Obama plant the White House kitchen garden on April 5th. Newman and Coleman planted the same variety of outrageous romaine lettuce grown, harvested, and eaten by astronauts on board the International Space Station. This is the eighth year Michelle Obama has welcomed students and others to help plant the garden. NASA's Associate Administrator for Science and Astronaut John Grunsfeld announced on April 5th he will retire from the agency April 30th, capping nearly four decades of science and exploration with the agency. Grunsfeld has directed NASA's Earth and Space Science activities since 2012, managing more than 100 missions, many that have produced groundbreaking findings and discoveries. He also was inducted into the U.S. Astronaut Hall of Fame in 2015. His five space shuttle flights include the last Hubble Space Telescope servicing mission in 2009. On that flight, Grunsfeld helped to successfully upgrade Hubble and became the last human to touch the iconic telescope. Engineers at NASA's Langley Research Center in Hampton, Virginia, recently began a series of water drop tests to understand conditions the agency's Orion spacecraft and crews on board may experience while landing in the Pacific Ocean after returning from deep space missions. Specially instrumented crash test dummies in the Orion test vehicle will gather data to help engineers ensure astronauts will be protected from injury during future splashdowns. Each test in the series simulates different wind conditions, velocities, and wave height scenarios that Orion may experience during parachute-assisted landings in the ocean. At NASA's Michoud Assembly Facility in New Orleans, final welding was completed recently on a liquid oxygen tank confidence article for NASA's new Space Launch System rocket. The rocket's 200-foot-tall core stage includes a liquid oxygen and a liquid hydrogen tank to feed the rocket's RS-25 engines. Confidence hardware verifies weld procedures are working as planned. All welding for the core stage is expected to be completed this summer in preparation for the rocket's first uncrewed test flight with Orion in 2018. During a recent visit to Ames Research Center at Moffett Field, California, NASA's Associate Administrator for Aeronautics, Jaewon Shin, was briefed on some of the work at the center, helping to advance green aviation technologies and concepts that support the agency's environmentally responsible aviation project. Shin also handed out awards during a ceremony to honor employees who have distinguished themselves with their work ethic during fiscal year 2015. A recent open house and membership drive sponsored by the Women of NASA Headquarters featured remarks from Deputy Administrator Newman, Chief Scientist Ellen Stofan, Brenda Manuel, Associate Administrator for Diversity and Equal Opportunity, and others. The new Headquarters Employee Resource Group seeks to encourage diversity, inclusion, and equity in the workplace, and support the advancement and professional growth of women in federal service at NASA Headquarters and throughout the agency. And that's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on social media and visit www.nasa.gov/twan.